What if the climate crisis were a medical emergency?
It is.
What if all of us were stage 4 climate patients?
We are.
What if we faced an epidemic of climate illiteracy?
We do.
Wouldn't you expect the institution entrusted with being the guardian of science and knowledge to take decisive action on behalf of its students?
But it isn't.
The scientists who diagnosed our condition work at this and other universities. Let's translate what they're saying.
The IPCC report on global warming of 1.5 degrees Celsius.
Our body temperature is rising dangerously.
The IPBES report on biodiversity.
Our immune system is collapsing.
The IPCC special report on land use and food security.
We are in danger of dehydration and starvation.
We're in a full-on medical emergency.
But to look at our institution, you wouldn't know it.
Business as usual is a vector of climate disease.
We need a climate patient's bill of rights.
We have the right to be fully informed of our condition.
We have the right to expect our institution to follow the scientists.
We have the right to work with our institution to take unprecedented action.
We have a prescription for pen.
Establish a climate requirement. Talk to us. We have good ideas.
Make climate action the topic of next year's pen reading project. Educate everybody.
Stop hiding climate action in facilities and real estate services. We need a center for climate action with an academic mission.
Set up a task force to establish guidelines to reduce air travel. Invest proceeds from necessary air travel to help West Philly decarbonize.
Eliminate plastics in review Penn campus dining and catering services.
Create healthy conditions for the Penn community to work together to address the climate emergency. Do all of that, and divestment will be a snap.
To quote Penn bioethicist Jonathan Moreno on the condition of American medicine,
we've been good at avoiding hard choices for a long time, but it's not sustainable. Come on, Penn! This is an emergency!